friends, Jen here with a book review for you of Phantom Heart by Kelly Creagh? I'm actually not sure how to say her last name. It's C-R-E-A-G-H. This is actually a library book, so I need to get it back. But this book is amazing. So I saw Phantom of the Opera a really, really long time ago, like maybe 10, 15 years ago. I didn't ever read the book. And my memory is like hazy. I remember really enjoying the play because I still have like the playbill or whatever it's called, but I don't really remember many details. So this book basically follows Stephanie, and her father like is always renovating houses, so they're always moving around a lot. And it generally follows the premise of the Phantom of the Opera. I think there is a guy who appears to her in her dreams. Their house is haunted. The guy wears different masks and things like that, and like later you realize like the masks are tied to different like emotions, and you find out why their emotions, basically. I'm trying to do a review without spoilers. There's also a modern day love interest in the story, and there's like a little group of friends that she meets at the school who are like paranormal investigators. So there's that like contrast or whatever, which I don't think the modern story has. There's the musical tie-in. Since Stephanie's mother has passed away, she doesn't really sing anymore, but she's a really gifted singer. So basically, there's the two storylines of the guy appearing in her dreams, a demon in her house or a ghost or something is in her house, and then the paranormal team of her, the friends that she's making in this new town. So this book is pretty long, and I read it in like, I think 5 sittings, and I was reading like 70 to 100 pages at a time. It's really fast paced. It's really good. I gave it 4.5 stars. The only reason I gave it less than 0.5 star is because I think the ending is true to Phantom of the Opera, but if I remember correctly, but I actually liked the modern day love interest. Personally. So, the ending was like, for me. There is like a little bit of an epilogue, but overall this book is really good. It's really fun. It's kind of creepy. It's, put into, I think Gothic is a category that it's marked as. It just came out, this is August 17th is when the library acquired it. So it just came out. It's really new. It's just really good. So you don't really have to have the background of Phantom of the Opera. Like I said, I really don't remember much to enjoy this book. If you like mystery, paranormal, gothic, romance. The romance is like important, but it's actually not, in my opinion, it's actually not like the complete forefront, which I like. I mean, it's a really heavy element, but it's like woven in really nicely. It's YA, kind of mystery, little bit of historical fiction, kind of. A lot about, like, if you really want to dive deep, there's a lot about, like, the soul and, you know, what happens to a soul and, like, how you can affect what happens to your soul and that all that kind of stuff in here. So you can dive deep if you really want to, but it's just really well written. It was really enjoyable. I wouldn't call it horror. There's nothing in here that really like super creeped me out, and it's not really particularly gory or anything like that. I mean, maybe a little bit like near the end, but overall this book is just really fun. The author is a huge fan of Phantom of the Opera, it says in the bio. I like this book so much that she has another trilogy called Nevermore, and I picked up 3 of those books used on eBay, and they should be here soon. So someone else saw my review of this book on like Instagram and said that she really liked Kelly's other writing as well. So I picked those up, and they have to do, it's kind of like a similar creepy element where like this girl in English class is paired with like the weird guy, and the weird guy writes stories, and like the stories are really dark, like Edgar Allan Poe-esque, and like come to life and things like that. So the covers are kind of lame from what I've seen, but the premise sounds really cool. This cover is really pretty. And this book is just, it's really good. So if you're looking for something kind of atmospheric going into October, then I suggest you check out Phantom Heart. And that's all I have for you today. In the meanwhile, stay introverted. Bye.